This kibble has 40% protein. This wet food has 11% protein. Which one has more protein? Kibble, right? No, you're wrong. Hey friends, it's Jess and Jericho from catechols.com. This video is all about the guaranteed analysis, how to read cat food labels the right way. So AAFCO says at minimum, guarantees must be provided for the minimum percentages of protein and fat and the maximum percentages for fiber and moisture. Notice that carbs aren't required on the guaranteed analysis. Yep, you have to calculate that yourself. But don't worry, I'll teach you exactly how to do that. Also, kibble and wet food have drastically different moisture contents, so we need to convert the guaranteed analysis numbers to a dry matter basis when we're comparing cat foods. Converting it to a dry matter basis just means removing the moisture. First, I have to mention that the National Research Council, the NRC, says that carbohydrates are not essential to the cat's diet. I mean, isn't it obvious that they aren't essential if AAFCO doesn't require them on the guaranteed analysis? Let's take a look at two examples. Here are two products manufactured by the same company, and both products fit under the 25% AAFCO product name rule. So that means they have the same minimum requirement of the named ingredients. Looking at the numbers for kibble, we have 40% protein, 19% fat, 2.5% fiber, and 12% moisture. Ash was not listed on the label, so I'm just going to use the same amount as wet. The wet food has 11% protein, 2% fat, 1.5% fiber, 2.7% ash, and 80% moisture. So first, let's calculate the approximate amount of carbohydrates in each food. Now, it's important to understand that these numbers are approximate because, as I mentioned, some of the guaranteed analysis numbers are provided on a minimum and some are provided on a maximum. We don't know the exact amount, so these are approximate calculations. That's why it's important to understand AAFCO product name rules and how to read the ingredients list. So using those two and the guaranteed analysis in combination with each other, that's how we compare cat foods properly. To subtract these values from 100 to see how much carbohydrate percentage we have, including moisture. Some people will say to include fiber and others say not to. Just to be conservative, let's include fiber. Based on these numbers, the kibble example has approximately 23.8% carbs, including moisture. Isn't it crazy that carbs aren't required on the guaranteed analysis? I mean, 23.8%? That's a high amount considering that carbs aren't essential to the cat's diet. Let's take a look at the wet food. Here's the wet food, and after our calculations, it contains approximately 2.8% carbs, including moisture. Give me a polydactyl thumbs up if you're getting value out of this. So already we can tell that this particular wet food is more suitable for cats simply because there's more moisture and there's fewer carbohydrates. Now we have to remove moisture from these values. So here are the kibble numbers, including our approximate calculated carb amount. We need to take 100 minus the moisture content, in this case 12, to find the dry matter basis of the entire food. The dry matter basis of this kibble is 88. Then we take each of the guaranteed analysis numbers and divide it by the dry matter basis of the entire food. Then we multiply by 100 to convert it back to a percentage. After this calculation, our dry matter basis of this kibble is 45% protein, 21% fat, and 27% carbs. Now, kibble numbers aren't going to change much because there isn't much moisture that we're removing from the equation. Let's take a look at our wet food values on a dry matter basis. Here are our wet food calculations. So we take 100 minus 80% moisture content, and we get 20 for the dry matter basis of the entire food. Now we take each of the guaranteed analysis numbers and divide it by 20, then multiply by 100. So our dry matter basis numbers for this wet food are 55% protein, 10% fat, and 14% carbs. So remember at first glance, we thought that the kibble has higher protein. It said 40% and the wet food said 11%. Now let's look at the comparison on a dry matter basis. Here are the dry matter basis numbers for each food. This particular kibble is 45% protein, 21% fat, and 27% carbs. This particular wet food is 55% protein, 10% fat, and 14% carbs. So it's important to make the connection here that this particular wet food has much more meat-based protein in the product because it has fewer carbohydrates. This particular kibble is about a third carbohydrates. See how crucial it is to compare calf foods on a dry matter basis? It's also important to calculate the carbohydrates because, again, these aren't required on the guaranteed analysis. So at first glance, this wet food didn't seem to have a lot of carbohydrates until we removed the moisture and converted it to a dry matter basis. Now, obviously 14% is still better than almost 24%, but it's still not ideal. I know it seems daunting at first to do all this math, but after a few times, it becomes second nature and comes really easy. It's also very easy when you know the product name rules and how to read the ingredients list. But I did the work for you and included my guide to high protein, low carb, wet calf food choices, and how to transition calf food properly. It's in the description below this video. Join me in the next part of this series on how to read calf food labels properly. Next, we're going to talk about all of the different label claims that don't mean anything. So for example, that label claim fresh means absolutely nothing in feed law. If you haven't seen the rest of the videos in this series, check them out in the description below this video. Thanks for watching. Get that ball.